Hi folks, and welcome to this Phantasm tutorial. I'm Sebastian Bleek, and in this episode I'll be taking you through how to use the dot gain curve graph in Illustrator. Overall, we'll cover the dot gain curve graph, adjusting input output levels, and curve modes. The dot gain graph gives you precise control of the halftone's response to tonal changes. It does this by varying the relative size of every dot from 0% to 100%. First, let's take a look at the dot gain curve graph. Operating this curve is the same as a curves adjustment in Phantasm and Photoshop. This provides the ability to darken or lighten your overall results. Here you can see I've already applied the default halftone settings. Down at the bottom in dot gain, that's where you're going to find the curve graph. To make an adjustment, just jump right in, click and drag on that line, and then release. All right, notice my artwork has a darker result. All right, so back over here in the graph, we've actually produced a node. I'm going to click on that node and drag it downwards, and then release. All right, now we have a lighter result for our halftone. What we're doing is we're telling Phantasm to hold on to the lighter tones a little bit longer. You could also add additional nodes. So over here in the upper right, I'm going to click and drag, then release. All right, so I've created this S shape in my curve graph, which is going to give me a little bit more contrast here in my halftone. Next, let's take a look at adjusting your input and output levels. Once you've added a node to your curves graph, you can make manual adjustments to fine-tune your halftones. Back over here in the curve graph, notice this node over here in the top right is filled in with black, but the one on the bottom is actually hollow. So the one filled in with black is targeted, and you see the information reflected over here in the bottom right. So we have an input value of 74 and an output value of 87. All right, I'm going to target this other node in the bottom left, click on it once. Now this one's filled in and the other one is hollow. We now show an input value of 27 and an output value of 6. A couple different ways to work with this is you could come in here and enter a specific value. So for input, I'm going to go with 30. And when I tab over, you're going to see that updated. And for output, I just wanted to show you that you could use the up arrow key to introduce a higher value and the down arrow key to enter in a lower value. And you're going to see that updated over here in your artwork. Now let's take a look at curve modes. There's actually two different ways to work. You could use a Bezier curve or a linear connection. Back over here in dot gain, currently we're working with the Bezier curve, but just next to it over on the right, if you click on this, now we have a linear connection. So you're getting more of a rigid graph, and you see that updated over here in the artwork. All right, to see the difference, I'm going to come back over here, click on Bezier, and you see a slight adjustment happen in there. And that's it for this tutorial. Overall, we've covered the dot gain curve graph, adjusting input and output levels, and curve modes. Make sure you watch the next episode in order to understand how to save and manage your presets when working with halftones in Illustrator. And don't forget, all of our plugins are available for a free trial at astutegraphics.com. Thanks for watching.